And here is my stencil. I know it looks absolutely like, what the fuck is going on? I don't understand anything. But this is only for people who are more technical. They will really understand how it works. For artists, I really do not suggest to use the thermal printers and stuff like this, because you just don't understand. But for technical guys who will understand this, the best, easiest way to know if your stencil is correct is to make like this. Hide the first layer and look on the actual image and make like this. And when you start to understand that everything what you need is there, you have it. It's like super easy. Then what you need to do, you always need to make the rotation in a horizontal, this flip canvas horizontal. The reason why, because thermal printer always prints it in a horizontal way, like a mirror way. And here you just start printing. I think this is number one. Second one is, you need always to make it black and white, because it must be done for a thermal printer. I don't know why, but this is how it works. Then we have one more. I don't really remember when is it. I need to find edges. Find edges here. Now this stuff finds every single edge what you have. This is the best way if you are making some kind of neo-traditional or something like this, because it will actually give you a stencil straight away. And it will be super easy to check as well. But with these fine edges, it will be a little bit hard to understand with this method. Oh, fuck, now it's as well turning. I don't know how. So you just need to flip this one in a horizontal and check in the same way. Okay, I need to go to the comments a little bit. Where the fuck is comments? And read what you wrote. Oh, it's a lot. Can you start over, someone, about these questions about the stencil, please? Procreate is nice, yes. I like it as well, but I don't like to make a stencils there because it is the same waste of time. If you're making realism, then you would do it on the paper. Absolutely, even more time you are wasting on Procreate to make a stencil. Okay, Roberto, only for you. What the fuck? Wait, I'm gonna remove everything. So, wait, how the fuck to delete this? So you can start recording right now. First we need is to copy this layer. Copy paste, then black and white. Here you choose what you like better. Then filter, high pass. Here you choose the detail amount, how you like to be dark. Let's make it a little bit darker this time. Then you go levels. Then you go in the middle and you have your stencil. Do like this to check if everything is good for you. Okay. One second. Photocopy, I have never done it. Maybe you can always do your own stencils how you like in Photoshop. The way why I use Photoshop for the stencils, because it's super easy and it doesn't take any time at all. You just do it and that's it and forget about it. Mm-hmm. About how to make stencils so it doesn't disappear. First, you must remove all fat from the skin. Everyone have fat on the skin. So you must use alcohol or disinfection solutions, but you must use this disinfection or alcohol on the skin, not only one time. If you touch the skin, it is warm, yes? Any body part. But if you go with this solution, like removing the fat few times, and when you actually gonna feel that skin is getting cold, this is the best way to start making stencil, because when the skin is cold, it means it have like absolutely no fat at all on the surface of the skin. Try this. You will understand it straight away when you're gonna clean it a few times with alcohol and touch the skin. It will be colder. Then, of course, wipe it out with a paper towel or something like this to make it dry. And then apply small amount of stencil stuff. I, for example, use, I have it somewhere, Hold Fast from Sorry Mom. You can use everything what you want. You can use Dettol if you want. You can use a fucking lubricant for vaginas or anal sex. It actually works as well. You can buy lubricant from pharmacy. It's extra excellent stencil making stuff. I was doing it when I just started tattooing, because back when I started tattooing, we had only this Mickey Sharp's bullshit Dettol, and we have lubricant from pharmacies. That's it. In Latvia. So apply this, a small amount, don't go a lot, and then apply your stencil. Like, apply it really hard, then take it out. Wait minimum 20 minutes until you start working. And how to check if your stencil dried completely, just do like this with the pressure on the stencil, just go down or up, whatever. And if it still makes the smudge effect, it's not dry yet. When it stops doing this, that's it. It's there for life. You will not remove this stencil. Part number two about this stencil removing. Can you please write in the chat who is using green soap or any other cleaning solutions while they're working? I'm gonna wait a minute until you all gonna write it down. Okay, I'll tell you what I use. I use only water. I don't use anything else. I don't use green soap, nothing else. And please, Burak, don't use alcohol. It's totally not cool. You're just over drying the skin and it will not help you at all while you're working. I am not telling about when you're cleaning before stencil. I'm asking while you're working. So no gasoline, no anything else. I just use water. The reason why? Because first of all, if you use water, it reduces the redness on the skin. Second of all, if you use water, it doesn't remove the stencil. And third, it doesn't smell or anything. Because when you're working 12 hours and you have this stupid smell of green soap every single hour, it really pisses me off. So mostly all pros are using only water and using sometimes these washing solutions or green soap in the end of the session. And they use it only to try to remove the stencil actually. You can clean everything only with the water. It will be much more better for you, for the customer, for tattoo, for a stencil, if you're gonna use only the water. And if you think color work is impossible to clean with water only, you're super wrong, because I use water only for more than 5 years. I don't even have green soap in my working station. I don't even remember how it looks like. So try this, only water. You have a trick to remove stencil that stays in one after 8 hours. Yes, I have. To remove the stencil, because in this situation, how I explain now, you will 100% gonna have a stencil after you finished work. It's just impossible to remove it later. But there is a tip how to try to remove it is, I don't even have it. Oh no, I have it. For example, we take a foam, this foam, like there is actually like a green soap mixed with water, and this special pipe makes it as a foam. So any brand you want, spray it on the skin, spray a lot of this foam, and then put plastic around for 15 or 20 minutes. But this foam must be like super, how should I say, with a lot of soap inside. So it's actually like a foam. The foam which not goes to the water after 1 minute. Foam what actually stays as a foam. And how to do it is, if you have bottle like this and you don't like what is inside, get this shit out. Put green soap, maybe 30%. The rest is water. Close it, shake it a little bit, and you'll freak out how great this foam will be. It will just stay like this foam for 24 hours, if you need it. So do like this, wait 20 minutes, but foam must be a lot under the plastic, not only on the stencil area, but all the tattoo, because there is stencil under tattoo. You just don't see it, especially on the darker parts. Wait 20 minutes, clean it off completely. You will lose a minimum 70% of the stencil. If it's still there, repeat. It doesn't matter that customer is like, oh man, I need to go home and stuff like this. No, you motherfucker, you stay here. I need to take a photo. Do it again and it will remove your stencil. But please don't use any kind of stencil removers on freshly made tattoo, because fuck, there are so much chemicals inside, and what you can get is a little burn of tattoo, which will fade. Second, get inside some kind of chemicals, which will raise infection. And third, your customer will be like, what the fuck, man, it's so burning. So don't use it. Use only foam, this one, or create your own, like I told you. It's even better. Yeah. Dettol as well. Dettol is made for cleaning surfaces actually. It's not made for the stencils or for the skin. With Dettol in England, for example, they are cleaning floors. So don't use Dettol. To remove a stencil before tattooing, I suggest you to use not alcohol, but these special solutions for stencil removing. I'm too lazy to stand up right now and go there and take one, but there is a lot of these stencil solutions on the market. You can buy any one. They are all the same, only the color is different.